Okay, fantastic. Okay, thank you. Our apologies. My apologies for the delay. It is 7:22, so we will kick off this Town of Frederick meeting. Megan, will you take the roll for me, please?
Trustee Mahan?
Here.
Trustee Brown?
Here.
Trustee Tivaldi?
Here.
Mayor Kreitz?
Here.
Trustee Lamach?
Here.
Mayor Pro Tem March? Trustee Padilla?
Here.
Okay, all right, thank you. Thank you for being here tonight. Let's stand and join each other in the Pledge of Allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, thank you. Megan, do we have any changes to our agenda or any special presentations this evening?
Mayor Kreitz, there was one change to your agenda. It was properly noticed, but wanted to point it out for the benefit of the public. We did add the appointment of some youth commissioners to your agenda, and that was noticed on the website and also sent out to you. And we do not have any special presentations this evening.
Okay. Thank you. Noted on our agenda tonight. We will add that item. Thank you. We'll roll right into public comment. This portion of the agenda is provided to allow members of our audience to provide comments to the town board. Please sign in and I will call you. Let's see, if your comment or concerns require an action, that item or items will need to be placed on a later agenda. We have no public comment at this time. We do have a public hearing, correct? Yes, public hearing action item H. So if you have public comment that you'd like to share during that item, you're welcome to do so. But hearing and seeing no public comment, we'll move right into staff reports, please. Ryan, would you start us off?
Yes, Mayor, members of the board, just a couple items I want to talk about briefly in the staff report. Kudos to our Colby and Tim at the golf course for the great work that they've been doing. I know we had a big event just this last week, the Globala tournament on Saturday evening. All slots were filled. We were successful and able to be able to have a caterer that was in Frederick to be able to assist us in that process. So just great job. I know even Colby's been doing some of the bartending duties and Tim, they've really done a great job in really moving the strategic goal of the board forward. And it has been successful in our opinion as well, not just with what the team has done, but also financially. So just wanted to give them kudos and appreciate all the great work that they're doing. Just a couple of other items. We have the community tour and talk as a reminder next week on Wednesday at Prairie Greens. We had a Fredway steering committee this last week. A lot of great work that's being done there. We will have a booth. In addition to that, we, as you saw in the sign-up genius, we'll also have a booth at the Frederick and Flight, which is also that week on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So there's some good stuff coming up. And then in addition to that, and I know Megan had sent out some information as well about the fire district Station 5 groundbreaking that's on Tuesday. So just a couple of things to keep in mind for that week next week. With that, that's all the things that I have for the admin report, Mayor.
Thank you. Any questions for Brian? Really appreciate the update on the golf course. Bless you. I think that's trending in the right direction. I think continuing to communicate that is a strategic goal is to continue to have the golf amenity in the Town of Frederick, but make sure that it's sustainable, financially. So if we can continue the communication for that somehow, I would appreciate that just so that I suppose goals don't get lost in translation. I think that's important to remind the community of why we've transitioned. And then share that data when we have it. Let's talk about those positive numbers as we get them in and share the why behind those decisions. I think that'd be very powerful.
Absolutely. Thank you, Mayor. We'll have another update. Probably things are pretty fluid. So in July, we'll have probably some more information. I'll have the team come and provide an update during an admin report as well.
Okay,
I think it's important. The public also can hear that, and then we'll get information out as well. But appreciate that.
Okay, so a July Bella Rosa update is in the plan. Okay, thank you. How about not necessarily part of your admin report, but a couple weeks ago when we met, we I think all voiced concerns with just the condition of Highway 52. Do we have any traction on that?
We do. In fact, I don't Yard. Great. The team had a meeting today with the state, with the Highway 52 representative, or the state representatives, and there's some good information. I believe we also have a date locked down for a study session. I think it's August 11th, to be determined, but Kevin.
Sure. Decono had a couple of representatives there, and then the engineering team met with the resident engineer, project manager. There were three of them from CDOT. We got good information. We got some contact information, and this just happened this morning, so I'll be sending out a summary of that. But there is a website you can look to. There's a phone number that when you have complaints, you can talk to somebody when you make a call in. And that call gets logged, it gets followed up with, and then sent back out. That was news to us. We've never had that level of understanding, but they showed us right where it was on the website, as well as the phone number to call. And so we got some good understanding on maintenance. Once you make that call in, then they send it to the appropriate person. So if it's a traffic signal issue, you'll be routed to the right person. If it's a pothole, that's a different area. So that was positive. We talked about the improvements on 52 that we're wanting to see. And I think one of the encouraging items we did get from them is that in fiscal year 26, they're going to be doing a resurfacing project from I-25 out to Highway 85. So the whole length of 52 will be milled, overlaid, and looking good. It's a couple years away, but again, it's in the plans, and that's how long it takes for these things to happen through the CDOT process.
Unless you post the phone number on social media, right?
Well, I'll let you.
I'll post the phone number.
But so good information there. I mean, it was something they were happy to bring up and talk about. There's also a meeting coming up on the. There's what they call is a 4P meeting. It's from 1 to 3 on the, I believe it's the 22nd of June. And it'll be at the Southwest Annex building. And you can go there and meet with the CDOT representatives and talk about issues you're having with the roads, with the congestion, with the maintenance.
Yeah.
So they'll be available to in person to be able to talk to.
Okay.
So they wanted to throw that option out there for us. And then what else was another one? Having Decono there, we were able to talk about potential projects that the two of us might align with a little bit. Decono had put in a request for, $2.5 million to do some design along Highway 52 from County Road 7 out to 15. And so that did make the list. Now, this is not CDOT. This is going through a different level of the legislature, but I think one of the senators that they were talking to. But anyway, it got identified. CDOT's aware of it. They definitely support anything we can do to supplement future work that they will have going on. So, but all in all, positive. Some good directions that we see coming, and just having that level, that line of communication pretty clear on how to reach out and talk to them, and getting face to face with their engineering staff that works on these projects. So,
well, I appreciate your advocacy. I think that's a component. I think maybe the residents or guests even of the town of Frederick don't recognize are happening, because they have complaints, rightfully so, about the condition of Highway 52, not even talking about widening or access points or development. They just want to drive their car and not fall into the abyss of a pothole. And I think they believe that we're advocating on their behalf, as we are, but it's a really difficult thing to be able to respond and say, hey, we are talking to CDOT, but just nothing's happening. And I suppose to me, that's not acceptable anymore. I mean, the road is we're not going to wait till 2026 for an overlay to fix the potholes. So
if
you have recommendations.
We'll come out and still do those smaller maintenance issues if you've got a large crack or you know, patch or something that needs done. They will take care of that. But knowing that there's a large project coming for the whole stretch will be good.
They're more conservative with their time than waiting for that project. Okay. Okay. Well, thank you for looking into it. I would love that phone number, please.
We'll have it in the morning.
Got it. Thank you. Appreciate it. Any other questions for Brian?
And Mayor and Board, we'll have that study session with CDOT on August 8th. Thanks to Megan. We've got it locked down and I think it's confirmed. So,
okay. Talking development specifically or just
general issues going on just with the state with highway, what their plan is with Highway 52 in the long term? When do we expect that to get moving and build that partnership or relationship best we can?
Yeah. Okay. Will Decono be at that meeting as well? Is it just us?
We can open it up to them. Absolutely.
Please. Okay, thank you. August 8th. Okay. Anything else? It's a very robust admin report. Thank you. Okay, Megan.
Thank you, Mayor. In your packet is a copy of the clerk's report. I wanted to point out a couple of items in the report and give you some updated information. So Judge Kahn held his first liquor licensing authority meeting last week for the temporary permit for Rumbo 52, who has filed an application for transfer of the license at 3768 Highway 52, or the former Pinocchio's location. It was approved, and so that business is able to begin operating under the current license while we do our investigation into the transfer. That hearing has not been scheduled yet, but will be scheduled soon. And I know that our town attorney will be reaching out to all of you for your thoughts and comments on behalf of the town, as we are an interested party in the application. In addition, on Monday, we have a new employee starting with the clerk's office. Her name is Melissa Miharis, and she will be taking over as our assistant town clerk, municipal court. Super excited to have her, and we'll be bringing her to introduce her to you soon. And then the last piece is just, we are still getting calls for peddler solicitor licenses. We are still holding them accountable and working with our police department to make sure that they are being cited accordingly if they are going throughout the town without proper licensing. But we have had many that have gone through the proper licensing channels. So we're communicating that both with our residents as well as with all of those that inquire as to our process and how that works. So I'd be happy to answer any questions that you have.
Megan, how is the new app on the phone working? The new app that we put out there for?
I would defer that question to Brian since it's being headed up by the communications team.
Yeah, Mayor and Trustee Lamock, it's been going really well. We've heard good things. Like we mentioned at the study session last week, we'll provide the board an update as we get more and more people involved with it. We'll be pushing it very heavily at the community tour and talk on Wednesday. But it's great. I've got it on my phone. It's so much easier we encourage the resident in terms of submitting a request, whether it's a pothole, whether it's weeds. You basically download the app, you take a picture of what your concern is, it goes in there, and then you as a resident, you can see when that gets resolved and where it goes to and what's done. It doesn't go into a dark hole, it gets resolved. So we'll have some more information on
that. Good responses, so to it.
Absolutely.
Good. I'm glad to hear that.
Trustee Lamock, that was the app you were asking about, not the Ring Central app, right?
Correct.
Okay.
The Frederick app.
Okay.
I just to add to that, I ran into my husband and I were walking to dinner and ran into one of the code enforcement folks, and he was already getting information straight to him on the app, and he was estimating that because people were using it, they were getting to him, days faster because it wasn't kind of being routed through email. So I think if you're using the app, you're kind of getting your question to the right place, which is really exciting.
Really nice. Streamlined process. Maybe CDOT should use it.
Perhaps.
Just a thought. Right. Any other questions for Megan? Those are great updates. Thank you. And let us know, yes, on the potential hearing for the liquor license. Thank you. Great. Thank you. Okay, we'll move on to our consent agenda. Our consent agenda items are considered to be routine and will be enacted by one motion and vote. There will be no separate discussion of a consent agenda item unless a board member so requests, in which case that item will be removed from the consent agenda and considered at the end of the consent agenda. You have three items on there. Would anyone like to remove any items or provide some direction, please?
Mayor Kreitz, I move to approve the consent agenda as written.
Second.
Trustee Tivaldi?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Padilla?
Yes.
Trustee Lamach?
Yes.
Trustee Mahan?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0.
Thank you. All right. Action item F. Kylie and Tracy. No.
I had moved the youth commission up to the top, but we're happy to do it at the end because the applicants aren't here.
They are here.
They are not.
Oh, they're not here. Okay, we'll save it to the end.
Perfect.
Thank you. Hi.
In the folder, yeah.
Good evening again, Mayor and Board of Trustees. My name is Kylie. I am the town's water conservation specialist, as I mentioned earlier, and I have been working on a turf replacement grant with our grants administrator, Tracy. And today I'll be presenting to you about it. And again, the acceptance of this turf replacement grant supports our strategic goal of strategic, reliable, and sustainable infrastructure. For the first time in 2023, the Colorado Water Conservation Board launched a funding program to support community programs focused on turf replacement with the goal of water conservation. We applied to this program a few months ago, and the town of Frederick was approved for a $25,000 grant. Staff will be budgeting a dollar-for-dollar match for this grant in our 2024 budget, and the amount proposed for this budget will not be greater than the amount we budgeted for 2023. This funding can be used for a few of our programs that we already have active, including our Garden in a Box program. As many of you may know, this program's been offered since 2016, and we offer it in partnership with Resource Central. This program provides $25 discounts on Garden in a Box kits, and these kits start at $123. And the kits include starter plants, a plant by number kit or map, and a comprehensive plant and care guide. And this is an example of what a Garden in a Box kit can look like at full maturity. This funding can also be used for our lawn replacement program. And this program is new in 2023. It's a program that was identified in our water efficiency plan. It is also offered in partnership with Resource Central. And in order to participate in this program, customers must show they're replacing watered and maintained turf with garden-in-a-box kits, or with plants. This year, we're offering up to $500 discounts for residential customers for lawn removal and garden-in-a-box kits. The cost of lawn removal is $2.50 per square foot, and customers receive a discount of $1.50 and have to pay $1. And garden-in-a-box kits start at $123, as I mentioned, and whatever is remaining of their $500 discount can be put towards those kits. And here's an example of a customer who removed turf and replaced it with garden kits. You have a picture just after those plants were planted and a picture of those plants at full maturity. We'll also be using this funding for the installation of 1,200 square feet of demonstration gardens throughout town. The purpose of these gardens, they'll be relatively small, but it's to encourage customers to participate in our programs, at least to start. I'll be working with parks and facilities maintenance staff to identify the best areas for these gardens. In summary, we'll be using this funding to expand our lawn replacement program in 2024. As I mentioned, we've offered 40 residential discounts of $500 this year. In addition to that, next year we'll be offering 5 discounts to commercial and industrial water customers of $1,000. And we'll also be offering 15 equity-focused discounts of $750, which will provide low-income residents in Frederick with up to 200 square feet of covered turf removal and garden kits. And as I mentioned just a minute ago, we'll be installing 1,200 square feet of demonstration gardens. I would like to point out that the number and dollar amounts of these discounts might change a little bit based on participation we see this summer in our program and based on pricing through Resource Central. So don't hold us to this exact thing. Ultimately, staff recommends the acceptance of this grant. We want to remind you that you'll see a line item for that budget match or funding match in our 2024 budget. And I also want to point out that there will be a second round of funding through the Colorado Water Conservation Board that opens up July 1st. So we will have opportunity to apply for that as well. And this funding can be used for municipal properties, for turf conversion at municipal properties, which I think we touched on during our work session. So this might be a good opportunity to tackle some of that. And I'll open things up for questions now.
Will the budget be twice what it was for 23?
Yes.
I have questions on the grant per se, but more on the process, if approved. On the lawn removal or the removal piece, what will we do with the turf that we remove?
That's an excellent question. So the turf that's removed from individuals' front lawns, I believe that is something that Resource Central handles separate from us. So they handle most of the program administration, and they're the ones who actually go in with their team and remove turf. Okay. That's a question I'm happy to ask them and get back to you about.
Sounds like they handle all of those services, though. They're doing the removal. Right.
It goes into another year.
They resell it to someone else.
They're a nonprofit focused on sustainability, so
reselling. Well, then you hope they're reusing it, right? Okay, and then how about on the, I think you and I talked about this a couple weeks ago, on the demonstration gardens, where there'll be signage for community members to understand what they're seeing, what they can participate in, what you have.
Yeah, thank you for that question, Mayor. Yes, there will be signage, and I've also budgeted for that in my budget that I'm going to be submitting to the Colorado Water Conservation Board soon. I want there to be QR codes on the signs, so if folks think the garden's beautiful, they can be brought right to the Garden in a Box page. Great.
Perfect, thank you. Have you identified places within the town of Frederick already that you're interested in having those?
Yes, Mayor, I have a small project I've identified actually to complete this summer right outside PD on 5th Street, and I'll be working to identify that 1,200 square feet of demonstration gardens after we submit the scope of work for this grant.
Trustee Brown, if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, just raise your hand function. You okay with that, Megan? Okay. All right. Okay. He's giving you a thumbs up. I'm sure he's giving you some kind of thing. Okay, some, if there's no questions, some direction on this item would be great.
Mayor Kreitz, I move to approve resolution number 23R25, a resolution of the Board of Trustees of the Town of Frederick, Colorado, approving support for accepting grant funds from the Colorado Water Conservation Board.
Second. Motion and a second. Any further discussion?
Trustee Lamont?
Yes.
Trustee Padilla?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Tivaldi?
Yes.
Trustee Mahan?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0.
Riley, thank you for presenting tonight. We're not nearly as scary as people say we are, right?
No, not at all.
Great. Yay, I'm glad.
Very welcome.
You did a very nice job. So thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
All right, item G. We know you well, so we're not going to be as nice to you.
Got a few different screens to work from here. I apologize. All right. So I'm going to try to paraphrase a lot of this because you've seen this once before in a work session and then a couple weeks ago at your meeting where we brought forth the draft ordinance language. So I don't want to belabor the point and redo everything, but I do know that there's some folks here in the audience perhaps listening online that this might be the first time, so we'll cover as much as we can. I want a special thank you to Sarah, who actually put together this PowerPoint and did a lot of the work but isn't available here tonight. So this ordinance kind of goes towards the strategic plan and in those two focus areas, as you see on the screen, strategic, reliable, sustainable infrastructure and community and economic vitality. Just as a way of background, the town has been spending a lot of time and energy over the last several years looking and planning our water future, looking at all the plans on the board. We've got the 10-year water resource plan, long-term water efficiency plan, which was already talked about at length today. And we're also currently underway with our comprehensive plan and the water rate study as well. Just as a quick overview, the long-term plan talked about what can we do to conserve water moving forward as a part of our strategy for our long-term water future, and kind of identified that we would be seeing potential savings through the conservation of water. And this is what this ordinance kind of plays into that process. So the water efficiency plan, excuse me, talked about it previous to today's meeting as well as the last agenda item, so I don't want to belabor that point, but it does identify several opportunities and ways that we can become more conscious of water in our uses and how we allocate water resources. And by this piece of it is how do we look at the requirements for dedications as we move forward. The landscape code update we talked about previously, so I won't belabor the point, but there's a lot of opportunities for looking at that, what that looks like. We got that direction from the work session this evening, and we'll continue to work in that direction. Municipal code updates, we've listed several of them here. Some of this work is continuing to be ongoing. We won't necessarily address all of these issues in tonight's ordinance, but a handful of those issues we will. And those issues are these here in the proposed ordinance for Chapter 13. We'll be dealing with the enforcement of water allocation exceedance. So for those folks that have kind of a lower water dedication at the front end, having a process to make sure that the town is made whole if those folks have overages in their usage in the future.
Also looking at some administrative efficiencies for the annual CBT contracts right now. The mayor has limited authority to sign off on those. A lot of them come back to the board, and so it kind of gums up your meetings. So looking at moving some of those processes that are more administrative in nature to just handle those outright rather than coming back to the board for all of those. The biggest piece is looking at what water we actually dedicate. A couple of the other pieces are the water demand analysis that's going to be prepared by staff to make sure that the water future for the town is protected. And then also looking at, you'll see this coming in the future, but setting up a structure for those kind of infill lots or special projects kind of in compliance with the feedback that we received this evening in water allocation policies. Kind of this ordinance touches on specific opportunities for infill development, et cetera, to do cash in lieu opportunities once those are identified by the board. So this doesn't create those today. It just creates the structure to allow that to happen in the future based off of the board's future actions. If the ordinance is passed, we mentioned this before, there's still work to be done in updating the code. So this slide kind of talks about what our next steps will be. We'll communicate these changes to the code out to the development community and the community at large. We'll still work on, as mentioned previous to tonight, that water allocation policy, the continued work on the land use updates, land use code updates, municipal code updates, design standards, etc. So this isn't the end of the process. This is just one of those very first steps as we move forward. All right. So it's very brief. You've already seen this twice before, but I'm certainly happy to pretend like I know what I'm doing when I answer any of your questions.
I do like the pace at which you went through it. It was very nice.
Right?
Right to the point.
Well done, Jason. Questions? I see everything we've discussed over the last 6 weeks written in this AM. So well done.
Right. And then it's procedure-wise, it is a public hearing, so I'd be available for questions, but you can open that up and incorporate this portion of the discussion into those, into that portion of the meeting.
Great. Next time, I should have opened that prior so that your presentation was a matter. So will you make sure that that's a matter of the public hearing, everything you just presented as well?
Absolutely.
Thank you. Okay, so open public hearing. Please take questions from the board if you have any, but we will provide an opportunity for the public to have any questions, comments, concerns on the water ordinance that we're considering tonight. Item G on your agenda. Yeah. Okay. I'll leave it open for just a moment if you all have questions in case something comes to mind.
More of a comment. I too really appreciate how comprehensive this is, and just want to recognize how much internal department and internal staff work still needs to happen to make sure that all the pieces are lining up with this vision that this ordinance creates.
I think it'll be a work in progress, right? I mean, this is certainly an ordinance, so it gives us some backbench, but I think we'll learn as we kind of roll out this process. Not have anyone who is just jumping at the opportunity to visit the podium. So we can...
And Mayor, I misspoke. This wasn't slated as a public hearing. I was confusing it with the later app. So... Prior
technically,
to
the whole thing is a public hearing, so it's completely fine. Okay. I will close the public hearing so that we can move on for procedure sake, but that does not mean if anyone has any questions, comments, or concerns, that you cannot still provide those. That's certainly more than fine. If not, some direction from the board, please.
Your Honor, if I could, one of the other things I did neglect to mention from last time we brought this up, the piece that was left outstanding for the board to consider for tonight was the date that you wanted this to be effective. So in the draft ordinance that's been presented, that's been left blank. By default, it would be 30 days after publication, but if you'd like to change that to something else, some point in the future, you can certainly do that.
Member consensus being comfortable with 30 days. Yes? Trustee Brown, I know you were passionate about this item, though, so if you have any thoughts on the 30-day implementation or effective date, please let me know.
I thought that we had discussed moving it out just a little bit longer to give people more time for processing. Am I correct in remembering that? I thought we had talked to even the end of July or beginning of August. I just can't remember.
I think it was just we weren't sure when we would see it tonight, whether it would be tonight or on a on another meeting, so we weren't sure. So we originally talked about 30 days after the ordinance was approved. But if you if you'd like to propose 60 days, that's okay.
Mayor Kreitz and Trustee Brown, just for context, with me needing to send it to the Times Call and their publication times, I'm estimating it'll probably be effective mid-July, so July 10th, July 11th, if you did the 30-day.
And the way the ordinance is drafted is we can put in a specific date if you want to just state, you know, August 1 is when this happens, so it's clean and clear.
I'd be comfortable with that if no one else objects.
All comfortable with an August 1 effective date?
Yes.
Right. That's all part of item G. If you were to propose a motion, please consider August 1 as your effective date.
I guess. Mayor Kreitz, I move to approve ordinance number 1386, an ordinance to Town of Frederick, Colorado, updating the Frederick Municipal Code for water dedication with an effective date of August 1st, 2023.
Second.
Trustee Padilla?
Yes.
Trustee Mahan?
Yes.
Trustee Tivaldi?
Yes.
Trustee Lamock?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0.
All right, let's go with the public hearing item H, and then we'll add Youth Commission after that. Are you okay with that? Okay, so I would like to open the public hearing for consideration of the Prosperity Subdivision Landscape Waiver. I think there's a few other components there, but public hearing officially opens so that Allie Van Dudekom's presentation is included.
Thank you, Mayor Kreitz. I've been advised by the applicant that he has a few comments but would like to table his item this evening. But I'd like for him to confirm that if you would allow.
Actually, let's take a 5-minute recess and you have all the time you need.
Okay.
Thank you. Allie, if you want to use the conference room.
irrigation systems are probably really expensive.
It's they're hard, a little harder to maintain because people can damage them very easily. They're not very far under the ground, so if you just stick a shovel in the ground,
okay,
you're done. Yeah.
All right, hold on. We'll wait for Brian at least.
Jeez.
Okay, we're okay? Minus Jason? Okay. All right, I have opened a public hearing. I am happy to reconsider opening that public hearing and or close public hearing and just move to general discussion. Is that what you'd like to do?
The applicant would like to table his item this evening, but he does have a few words for you all.
Okay.
Before we do that.
Would you like that in a public hearing? Or
attorneys?
Right, I would imagine you'd have that comment, whatever it is, captured in that public hearing. And then whether you choose to close the public hearing or continue it to the next date. Okay. Because I would imagine, unless he's withdrawing completely, if it's a request to continue it, then you'd continue the public hearing to that point.
Okay. Public hearing is still open, and we'll invite your applicant and welcome to share as many words as you'd like.
Evening. Richard Jablonski. I represent the Prosperity Subdivision. If you review the packet that we did submit that I want to make a presentation on tonight, it's right along the lines of what the water efficiency plan that the town is promoting and trying to work into your code. In lieu of your last acceptance of that ordinance, and we can now work with doing the water demand analysis, which we prior to this we weren't allowed to do because we didn't have non-potable water for the subdivision. I think it's a real positive move forward by the town's part. I think the town's old code wasn't mindful of the cost of CBT and the limited supply of that finite resource. And with this, it allows projects, with the passing of this ordinance, it allows projects like mine, and it gives us incentive to save water now. And prior to this, there was no incentive to it. So I think it's a positive move forward, and we look forward to working with staff and doing a water demand analysis and not putting any more water on the ground than we need to. So thanks a lot. Appreciate it. So
thank you for your time.
It's I did provide a date to the applicant that he was amenable to August 8th. So if the board wishes to continue this public hearing, it would be to the August 8th, 2023 board meeting.
And that would include a re-notice, yes?
If you table to a date certain, we do not have to re-notice the project, but we can if you'd prefer.
Information.
I think I know it's a pain in the process and time commitment and resources, but I think it's appropriate to renotice.
That's no problem.
No kidding. Thank you. Okay. August 8th. Yes. Okay.
And directing staff to renotice.
And we can continue that public hearing on August 8th. Yes, great.
We need a motion for that.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Madam Mayor, I move to, remind me which agenda item this is, G?
H.
H. I move to table agenda item H per the applicant's request to August 8th and direct staff to renotice the information for that agenda item at the meeting.
Second.
Motion and a second.
Trustee Tivaldi?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Trustee Lamock?
Yes.
Trustee Padilla?
Yes.
Trustee Mahan?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0.
Thank you.
Mayor, if I could, just as a word to those who may be listening and also to the board members, because the matter is still pending and we've continued the public hearing. If you do get questions, we'd encourage you to send those folks to staff so that we can appropriately capture that information in a way that's respectful of the quasi-judicial nature of the case.
With regards to that development.
Correct. So if you get questions, the best answer is to say, hey, I can't talk about this right now. It's still pending. If you have comments, you either come to August 8th or get in touch with staff and we'll make sure that that information is provided to the board altogether so that the process is preserved.
For clarity, specifically about the items that will be addressed in the agenda item, not the development itself.
Correct. The waiver itself is what's at issue.
Great. Okay, thank you. Yes, thank you for the reminder as well. Appreciate it. Thank you, Allie. Yeah. Okay, we do have an additional item I, Youth Commission. Megan, would you like to present that?
Yes. Thank you, Mayor Kreitz, members of the board. Tonight you have two appointments to the newly established Town of Frederick Youth Commission on your agenda. Unfortunately, the two applicants had other personal things on their agenda for tonight and were not able to attend. However, if they are appointed, I have invited them to come and meet you at a later meeting. On June 9th, Trustees Padilla, Brown, and various members of staff participated in a panel to interview these two applicants. Following the interview, we do have the recommendation to appoint both Peyton Siders and Brianna Wolf to the Frederick Youth Commission. I would defer to Trustee Padilla and Trustee Brown for any additional commentary on the appointments, but they are the first two appointments of 20 vacancies, so we're moving forward.
I will defer to Trustee Brown. I just want to recognize Anthony in the back, who was a youth commissioner and who is also staff liaison, is really perspective is really valuable for us.
Thank you, Trustee Padilla. Both of these students we found to be excellent candidates. We had a great time interviewing them, talking to them, and just getting to know them a little bit better. One of the things that we came across while interviewing them was a recommendation or a desire that they knew several other people that would love to be part of this commission. However, the biggest problem was they did not reside in Frederick. We talked with the committee and we talked to town attorney and just had some questions on would it be possible to open this up to students that are not in Frederick. We wanted to bring that as a discussion for tonight because I think there's an opportunity to get a better wealth of kids who do have Frederick's best interest in heart because this is where their school is. So I think that would be part of it. There's students that are from Firestone, students from Tocono that would love to be part of something like this that either just may not be offered at this time in their town, but they care about what's going on here in Frederick because of their school being here. So we wanted to bring that to the board tonight to see if we could offer some kind of opening the parameters to maybe allow a higher amount of applicants. One of the big discussion points was, if there were 20, 25, 30, 40 applicants that were all from Frederick, this wouldn't be an issue. But in the time that we had it open, there were only the two applicants that came forward. So that's something that we'd like to discuss tonight and possibly move staff to change that where I think Megan said that if we did that, she could make it on the application available now, just pending the wording, but I may not have that correct from memory. So I will defer back to Megan to help kind of clarify those thoughts and see if we had any discussion about that tonight.
I don't want to interject or steal Megan's thunder, but the resolution that was passed specifies that they have to be a resident of the town of Frederick, but we can certainly adjust that language to whatever parameters the board feels comfortable with. The more broad you leave it, the more discretion you give to that interviewing group and then yourselves later to make those appointments, as opposed to saying, a resident of Frederick, Firestone, or Tocono, because there's unincorporated pockets here and there, or if you'd like to just say the Frederick area and surrounding areas, and then you have that flexibility. You can put whatever parameters you'd like in terms of if that's the direction that we would receive. We would feel comfortable opening up the application process, knowing that it'll take time to get applicants, time to interview, time to bring back folks to be appointed, and we could have at the next meeting in the consent agenda an update to that resolution so it all comes cohesive all at once, if that's the...
So we could narrow it down to students in good standing at Frederick High School.
And that's the way it's currently drafted, is it's...
Or live in Frederick, because they could live in Frederick and go to Mead.
Right, so there's the way that it's currently drafted is we didn't specify where they go to school, because they can go to school elsewhere but live here. but again, you could set the parameter Frederick resident or attendee at Frederick High School if you'd like. Or if you're liking to make it more open to just Carbon Valley kids
Carbon to come Valley. Have a... Yeah, but what if there's an exchange student that's going to Frederick, you know? Why couldn't they do it? Right. Anyway, I just see like that going to the school or from Frederick makes sense to me.
Right. And ultimately, you know, that interviewing committee and then ultimately the board making these appointments officially, if there's folks that are too far beyond what you feel is reasonable or don't meet, you can always say no to those applicants if you'd like to.
One of the items. Go ahead.
and just to highlight Trustee Tivaldi's point, you know, we do have students that live in Frederick but go to Mead. We have students that live in Frederick and are homeschooled. We have those things. Something to consider is should... The future prospects of St. Vrain School District and a future school be involved, as I know they're in the early discussions of that, you could have kids that are going to school in Frederick but live in Erie, as we probably even still do now. So that just, I think, I do like the thought process of the broader but contained description that we use leaves it more open to a wider range of students, knowing that ultimately we as the board will have the final approval coming forth from the committee.
I think it'd be really good if Trustee Brown came up with something we could all agree with.
Yeah, you recommendations. Have the most
knowledge on this matter. Why don't you make a recommendation?
Oh, let's see.
Any student that is interested?
Perhaps it could be a member of the greater Carbon Valley area with a vested interest in matters related to youth.
That it would still have the parameters of age, grades, good academic standing in some sort of academic program, whether it's homeschool, that covers the gambit. And then you could, in theory, throw in a part of the application process, describe your tie to Frederick and have that
good
be.
Idea.
Like applicant to say why.
Yeah, I think like between that. Megan's description and then that part of because it ultimately, you know, at present with this commission moving forward, it is, you know, how can we benefit and help these kids out via the scope of Frederick? So I think it's not so much necessarily that they're living in Frederick, that their street address ends in Frederick, Colorado, but that they want to be involved in helping the town where their school is or where there's a lot of stuff going on. So I like Megan's description, and then I like Jason's, you know, tag in there about Frederick.
It's not like we're establishing a precedent. We have people on other commissions and committees that have vested interests in Frederick that are not living in Frederick. Right. So I don't have any issues with it.
And you should have to have blue hair. And
that's a reasonable request, honestly. I think if you can get 20 youth to raise their hand and say they want to participate, let's find less reasons to say no.
I like that. I mean, I think the more we can get involved, the wider opinion we can get involved, the better off it'll be. So,
the more. And just to give some... diversity in the two young ladies that came in and applied, and that we, as we interviewed, their scope and interest at this level are varied and different. Their focuses for what the youth need or want to be involved with are different, but they're involving just such a wide array from, you know, how do we keep our students interested in what's going on with the town? How do we keep them involved and active in the community? How do we help them and benefit them through some of the different trials and tribulations that they're going through? Two really neat, dynamic, different young ladies that just both in the interview process expressed that there are other people out there that want to help and be part of this, that just that one little hiccup of they don't actually live in Frederick is what's holding them up. So I think this will give us an opportunity. And I wholeheartedly agree that let's take out as many obstacles as we can if we have kids in the range of 14, 18 that want to be involved in making this community a better place to live for everybody.
Mm-hmm. That sounds good. So is that, will that component be rolled into the approval of Peyton and you said Frederick? Frederick?
So that the resolution update isn't on the agenda for tonight, but so I would handle it separately. I think I'm hearing a consensus that you'd like to see that resolution brought back. So we'll have that for the next meeting. I think the language would be changed instead of reside within the town of Frederick to reside within the greater Carbon Valley area with a vested interest in the town of Frederick. And so I'll bring back that change in a separate resolution that you'll enact after it's been properly noticed.
Okay, that's helpful. Thank you.
So and we will be able to move forward with, just to make sure that we understand this, that as of, you know, ASAP, we will be able to move forward with taking those applicants in, even though the resolution is probably not going to come until mid-July, as that's when our next meeting is, correct?
Right. So the way that structurally we would have this resolution brought back as a part of the consent agenda at the next meeting, that action item typically would happen prior to any other agenda items. And so that would, this would be in place before any appointments actually occur. The idea being that you all give it your blessing for us to move forward with recruiting folks under this new criteria, but they won't actually be appointed until after the resolution's done.
Great.
That's great. Thank you.
But as for tonight's two, we still need a motion. So I would love to move that we accept Brianna Wolf and Peyton Siders as our two newest members to the Frederick Youth Commission.
Okay.
Trustee Lamach?
Yes.
Trustee Tivaldi?
Yes.
Trustee Mahan?
Yes.
Trustee Padilla?
Yes.
Trustee Brown?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0.
Great. Thank you. Thank you for all of your work on this new commission too. Appreciate it. All right, let's buzz through some trustee reports. Please, anyone?
Nope. Well, you were talking to Brian about your
trustee report. Yes, we're gonna pause on it. Oh. But was that your trustee report? Was to remind me about my trustee report? Yeah.
To remind you about your mayor report.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
My report was just the youth commission, so that's good.
Exciting.
Nothing.
Kev, you have anything?
It's raining here just like it's been raining back home, so I'm living the life you guys are living. It's just an hour later.
Oh. No fun. Rain's a good
thing. Other than that, nothing to report.
Good. I'm glad you're doing okay. Even with the rain. I do not have any items as well. Do you all have any items?
I just have one item, Mayor Kreitz. So you do not have another Board of Trustee meeting until July 11th. Now you do have a number of events coming up and community barbecues, but we will not meet until July 11th. So have a lovely June.
And on that note, just a reminder, business roundtable tomorrow, if you can make it here at 8 o'clock in the boardroom.
Yeah, do you have... I heard rumor that there weren't very many that were able to sign up to that 10. Wow.
Could I ask how long something like that goes? And if I had to leave after a half hour, is it still worth
for a little absolutely. Bit? Yeah. It's pretty open and laid back and they'll have not questions. Like, no.
Rude to then have to leave quick. Okay.
I don't suppose it'll be Zoomed, will it? I don't need something special just for me.
I don't think it is Zoomed.
No,
I think it's just more casual.
Yeah, it's pretty casual.
Cool.
Us meeting.
But we can. The team did a great job. Ryan and Max and Sierra. We can send out notes as questions that came up in the meeting and give you a summary of what happened as well. So
that'd be fantastic.
Yeah. Yep. Very helpful. Thank you. Okay. If there's nothing further, we can be adjourned. Thank all of you for your time. See you in July. Not really. See you all on Wednesday.
Not me.
You're not going to be there on Wednesday?
No, I can't. We got tickets to go see the Book of Mormon.
That's right. I would like to hear how that is.
I've